Welcome all of you. Now we'll begin with the illustration of the unit numbers, classification, prime numbers and divisibility rules. We are going to see some illustration where whatever you have seen in the first video of the concept will be demonstrated, illustrated with numericals. Let's see an example. How many of the following numbers are divisible by 77 is the question. We are going to check all the numbers one by one, whether they are divisible by 77. However, by using divisibility rule, let's see the first example. 6, 8, 5, 3. Now we wish to check whether 6, 8, 5, 3 is divisible by 77. What we will do? We will find co-prime factors of 77. 77 is equal to 7 into 11. Now, how we are going to use this rule of divisibility? If a number is divisible by 7 as well as 11, where 7 and 11 are co-prime factors of 77. What is co-prime? Co-prime is basically they do not have anything common in them. So out of the two factors, one could be prime, one could be non-prime also, or both could be prime also. But essentially, they do not have any common thing in them. They do not have any common factor among them. So 7 and 11 are the co-prime factors of 77. So we'll check it whether it is divisible by 7. We'll check it whether it is divisible by 11. Let's check by 11. Look here. Now, what is the rule of divisibility of 11? In divisibility rule of 11, we know that alternate digit, we go for sum. Here, 6 plus 5, 11. Alternate digit will sum. This is 5, 3. Okay, now this correction is 5, 3. So we'll make it, this is 11. Now we are supposed to check whether divisibility by 77. The number is 6, 8, 5, 3. Now 6 plus 5 minus 8 plus 3. So these two numbers sum. Minus these two numbers sum, we get 11 minus 11 equal to 0. What is the divisibility rule of 11? If the sum of the alternate digit, when difference of the two sums is 0 or divisible by 11, then the entire number is divisible by 11. This rule is clearly telling that this number is divisible by 11. We can check the rule whether it is working properly or not. 6, 8, 5, 3, we'll try to divide by 11, 11, 6, 66, we get 2, 11, 2, 22, we get 3, and 3 down, yes, we have verified it is divisible by 11. Now we have to check whether it is divisible by 7 or not. We have checked divisibility by rule, while for 7, we'll directly check whether it is divisible by 7 or not. And we realize that dividing by 7, I'll get 63, 5, and then I get 49, I'll get 6 here, and 3, 7, 9. That means this number is divisible by 7, we have verified. This number is divisible by 11, by divisibility rule we verified. Resultantly, this number is divisible by 7 as well as 11, and there is nothing common in 7 and 11, and therefore definitely this is divisible by 77. Now let's check another example and we'll proceed ahead. Hold it. Let's check next example. What is the next example? 4774. Look here. 4774. We'll go a little bit fast. How? 4 plus 7? 11. 4 plus 7? 11. 11 minus 11? 0. So this is divisible by 11. Check it whether it is divisible by 7. I'll get 42, 5, 7. How much? This will be 57. I'll go by 8. I'll have 56, 1, 4, 14, 0. This is divisible by 7. So second number is also divisible by 77. Then 3782. This is 8 plus 3, 11. And 7 plus 2, 9. 11 minus 9, 2. What do we say about this? The difference between the sum of the alternate digit, when I take the difference, it is 2. This is neither 0 nor divisible by 11. So this is not divisible by 11. So this is not divisible by 11. So this is not divisible by 77 also. And the last number we check, 6314. Let's check for 11. 6 plus 1, 6, 6, 3, 1, 4. 6 plus 1, 7. 3 plus 4, 7. 7, that is 6 plus 1 minus 3 plus 4. Alternate digit sum is 7. Alternate digit sum is 7. So is equal to 0. So this is divisible by 11. Let's check whether it is divisible by 7. Yes, it is divisible by 7 also. So 6314 is also divisible by 7 and 11. So we realize that out of all the numbers, only 3782 is not divisible by 77. Question is, how many of the following numbers are divisible by 77? And we check the divisibility by 7 and 11 and concluded the divisibility by 77. Let's see, the solution is also illustrated in the next slide. Yes, and now we try to solve the example at the end of it. As the illustration is also mentioned over there, the next example, how many of the following numbers are divisible by 18? Now, let's see how many numbers are divisible by 18. I am going to illustrate one or two numbers in this, and you are supposed to check for all the numbers. Now let's see number 14094. Now we have to check whether it is divisible by 18 or not. Now I will go for two co-prime factors of 18. Out of that 2 is prime, this is non-prime. But this doesn't have anything common with 2. So this is a pair of co-prime factors. We try to divide by 2, we try to divide by 9. If it is divisible by both of them, then it is divisible by 18. Now, what is the rule by 2? The last digit should be divisible by 2. It should be 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Yes, it is divisible by 2. Nothing to worry about. What is the rule for divisibility by 9? The divisibility rule for 9 says that sum of the digits of the number, I'll make it 1 plus 4 plus 0 plus 9 plus 4. 1 plus 4 plus 0 plus 9 plus 4. This is 18. If sum of the digits is divisible by 9, yes, it is divisible by 9, hence this number is divisible by 9. It is divisible by 2, divisible by 9, hence divisible by 18. This is the way we handle the thing. Other numbers also you can try, and the answers will be told to you in due course. Let's go for next example. Yeah, it's a different type of example. What is there in the example? Find the smallest number which when multiplied by 120 gives a perfect square. Let x be the smallest number. Which when multiplied by 120 gives a perfect square. The moment we realize that, we need a perfect square. Now 120 into x should be perfect square. So what we do? We want that 120 into x should be a perfect square. For that, what we do? We factorize 120 so that we try to find out how many perfect squares are there in 120. Look here, 120, 2 into 60, 2 into 2 into 30, 2 into 2 into 2 into 15, all right, now is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Now we realize that 2 into 2 is a square of 2, it already exists here, but 2, 3, 5, these numbers are existing only once. Now, if I get multiplied by another 2, multiplied by another 3, multiplied by another 5, it becomes complete square. So, what I do, 120 into x is equal to 2 into 2, 2 into 2, I have written like this, into 2 into 3 into 5, I am writing like this. Now, this 2 into 2 is what? 2 square. I'll write it like that. 2 square. But 2 into 3 into 5 is only once. It will become square if it is multiplied by that. So, what we'll do? 2 into 3 into 5. Now, we realize that this number is 120. And therefore, this number must be x. And so, we got the value of x. What is the value of x? 2 into 3 into 5. So, that is 30. That means if 120 is multiplied by 30, it gives a perfect square. What perfect square it will be? 2 square is there. 2 square into 2 into 2, this is 2 square. Into 3 into 3, this is 3 square. Into 5, this is 5 square. So typically we find it is 2 into 2 into 3 into 5 whole square. So 120 into x is a square of 2 into 2 is 4, 4 into 3 is 12, 12 into 5 is 60, 60 square. So it will become 60 square. So 120 into x becomes 60 square, wherein x is 30. Thus we get the solution. Check. Next. Look here, the illustration is being made over there. And as an exercise, you are given a problem. Find the smallest number, which when multiplied with 588, gives a perfect square. On the same lines you can work and you can definitely get a perfect square. The answer will be shared with you later on. Let's see another example. Next. Look, example 3. What is there in the example 3? In example 3, we find it's of different type. When a number p is divided by 11, it leaves 7 as a remainder. When the square of p is divided by 11, what will be the remainder is the question. So we go with the basic principle of the formula. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Now, if you consider a formula, I can denote dividend by S is equal to divisor D into quotient Q plus remainder R. Now, with the help of this formula, we are going to analyze this type of problem. How we are going to analyze this type of problem? When a number P is divided by 11. So, typically, P will be our dividend, like S. Dividend will be P. When the P is divided by, this is divisor. Divisor is given as 11. When P is divided by 11, some quotient I will get here, Q. And however, the remainder is given as 7 as remainder. So typically, P is equal to 11 Q plus 7. And question is now, when the square of p is divided by 11, what will be the remainder? What we'll do? We'll take square of p. Look here. P square is equal to what? 11 q plus 7 whole square. Now, we can use the formula a plus b whole square. What is the formula? A plus b whole square. A plus b square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now, let's take this formula. It will happen 11 q will replace a first term square plus 2 times first term into second term plus second term square. A plus b whole square, a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now let's try to separate the factors in this. This will be what? 11 square q square, no issues, plus 11 times 2q. Sorry, 2 into 7. So we'll say that it is 11 times
I'll just
rub it. It will be 11 times 2 into 7 into cube. So 14 cube plus 7 square is 49. Now we know that 11 square means it is having a factor 11. So this is divisible by 11. Sure. This is having factor 11. So this is divisible by 11. So we will break up 49 so that we'll find what component of 49 is divisible by 11 and what is left out. Check 49. How much is divisible by 11? 11 into 4. 44 plus 5. Can we express 49 like this? Yes. If we can express, I will take out 11 common from this. 11 square, I have taken 11. So 11 will remain. 11 q square plus 11 into 14 q. 11 I have taken out. 14 q. So from the first two terms, I have already taken out 11. From this, I would like to make it out. Now here I know that this is 11 out into 4 plus 5. So out of 49, I could get one more term called as 11 into 4 and plus 5. I'll sum it. I'll take 11 common. 11 q square plus 14 q plus 4. 11 q square plus 14 q plus 4. 11 common from both. And plus 5. So this is a divisor, this is a quotient, this is a remainder. And therefore, when p square is divided by 11, we get the square bracket as quotient. We are not interested in its value. Remainder is 5. So when p is divided by 11, it gives 7 as a remainder. When square of p is divided by 11, what will be remainder? The remainder will be 5. We could analyze in this way. Let's see the analysis in the next slide. Yes, it is nicely depicted in the next slide how we understand. And another numerical is given over here for your exercise and practice. When a number p is divided by 13, leaves 9 as a remainder. When the square of p is divided by 13, what will be the remainder? Look here, on the same lines you have to try and find out what will be remainder. This is third type of the problem. Let's see next type of the problem, fourth problem. Read the fourth problem. Try to assimilate the concept in the fourth problem. Before we start analyzing, have a little bit conceptualization of the problem so that you can proceed ahead. Now, what is the difference between the place value and the face value? Now, you understand that the place value is basically in at what place the digit is there. The number is 473. 982. Practically, if you consider here, what will be this number? It is in unit place. So its value will be 2 into 1. This is at 10th place. So its value will be 8 into 10. This is at 100th place. So its value will be 9 into 100. This is at 1000th place. So value will be 3 into 1000. You understand this? The place value is multiplied by what is the digit value, that is the face value of the digit, multiplied by its positional value. This is 10 to the power 0, 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 2, 10 to the power 3, 10 to the power 4. Now look here, we find here 7 into 10,000. And this will be 4 into 1 lakh. 10 to the power 0, 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 2, 10 to the power 3, 10 to the power 4, 10 to the power 5. So place value of this 7, place value minus face value. Place value will be what? 7 into 10,000. And face value is the digit itself. Face value will be digit itself. So this will be 70,000 minus 7. So answer is obvious. 69,993. Now if you consider only the place value of this and face value of this, we are not bothered about this 43982. Okay, let's see the illustration. Next slide. Look here, it is being illustrated. And now a small exercise given to you. Find the difference between the place value and face value of 9 in the number 56934. Look at the face value of 9 is 9. Look at what position it is.
is it unit position, 10th position, 100th position, 1000th position? Make it like that, multiplied by 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 0, 10 to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Let's see the next type of the problem. Yeah. Read the problem, try to understand, and try to check how you will handle this problem. Let's see how to take care of this problem. Read the problem so that you can have a first-hand feel how to go about it. Find the smallest number which, when subtracted from 4455, gives a number divisible by 6. 4455. Now, divisibility by 6, we understand 6 I divide into 2 parts, 2 into 3. So, these are the co-prime factors of 6. So, if it is divisible by 2, divisible by 3, then divisible by 6. Understood. Last number is odd, 5. So, it is definitely not divisible by 2. So, we would like to find out which number it is divisible. Is it divisible by 3? Yes. What is the rule for divisibility by 3? Sum of the digits, all the digits, 4 plus 4 plus 5 plus 5. 4 plus 4 plus 5 plus 5. Now, sum is coming to be 18. Now, 18 is divisible by 3. As the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, the entire number is divisible by 3. So, we know this is divisible by 3. But not divisible by 2. So, we have to check any number less than that, which is divisible by 3 as well as 2. Now, next number divisible by 3 will be what? 3 less. So, in place of that, immediate number less than this, 4454 is not divisible by 3, it is only 1 less. 4453 is not divisible by 3, it is 2 less. But if I go for 4452, it is divisible by 3. 3 less means we are subtracting 3. You check, the total will be what? 4 plus 4 plus 5 plus 2 is equal to 15. Divisible by 3, so divisible by 3. And as I have subtracted 3 from this, from the odd, it has become even number. So even number is divisible by 2. So this is divisible by 2 as well as 3. And it is just less than this. And therefore, find the smallest number which, when subtracted from 4455, gives a number divisible by 6. This is the number divisible by 6, just below 4455. So I'll get 4455 minus 3 is equal to 4452. Now this is the number which is divisible by 6. This is divisible by 3 only, but not 2. And therefore I have to subtract 3 from it. So answer for this problem is, find the smallest number which, when subtracted from 4455, gives a number divisible by 6. We started checking the number itself, tried by 3 and 2, not divisible by 2. Tried for 3, yes, divisible by 3, but then that is not divisible by 2, so we have to check down a number just below it, and we try to go minimum away from 4455. So we realize that when we subtract 3 from it, it ensures divisibility by 3, but check whether it is divisible by 2. Yes, 4452, last digit is 2, so divisible by 2, and thus we could get a number just below 4455, which is divisible by 6. Now, these are the examples. These are the example where we can find out the fundamental rules of how to get a prime number, fundamental rules of the handling the prime numbers, handling the prime factors, fundamental rule of handling with the numbering is being addressed. And different 5 types of problems we have considered. See the next slide, the solution part of it. Look here, 4455 and how it is being handled. Now, exercise is given with a small example. Find the smallest number which, when subtracted from 6161, gives a number divisible by 18.